Hey guys, welcome back to the Baddest Dudes Play, Bioshock Infinite. This is Cactus here.
This is Showtime.
Checking in, here we are.
Yeah, so the game before this was Bioshock Finite. And
we decided to change the Infinite version.
Yeah, we didn't like the Finite version.
Yeah, that's not very fun.
So, but we're going to go to Comstock's house.
Oh yeah, we're still on his way.
Finally!
To his fucking house.
Oh, I can't wait. It's going to be so much fun because Comstock is the guy that, like, is the guy of this game.
Yeah, right? He's the prophet, so we're trying to stop him, so we're going to his house.
Exactly.
So that he'll stop trying to fucking kill us, which, I mean, we're just killing everyone else, so.
Right.
No skin off our back.
Most people deserve to die in this game. Except for, like, when we go to coffee shops and, like, slit, you know,
random people's throats. I mean,
yeah, that's fine too, apparently.
Yeah, but, like, I just do what I want.
But would you do it in real life? Probably not.
Oh, shit.
get that bomb in the rail.
I'm gonna shot from all over.
I can see you.
I can't get off.
We gotta follow the dismount prompt. So, can you explain as to why, like, now there's guys that have, like, these crazy-ass fucking helmets?
Because we're in a further part of the game where everyone's, you know, we've progressed a lot, so everyone's a lot fucking harder.
So okay, fair enough.
That's like armor, you know?
Fair enough. There's no, like, plot explanation with that?
I mean...
Oh, there's the jester guy that we liked before in the last episodes.
I mean, that's pretty much it. We're pretty far in the game, and now we're just facing the Vox Populi, who are apparently in the... I think... that they're just, like, pretty advanced in this time period, or this dimension that we're in, so...
Okay.
I don't know, that's a loose explanation.
Goddamn looseness.
Yeah, fucking loose.
Sometimes you love it, sometimes you hate it.
Oh, shit, I got a handyman. That sucks.
Oh, well, handymen are okay with me.
Well, yeah, but I'm, like, up against a lot of guys up here. I'm working with a stupid gun, though.
Handymen are cool, though. Like, a lot of people want to be like, oh my gosh, Cactus has to fight a handyman now.
What? I'm scared to fight him. I don't like fighting.
No, but I'm saying the audience wants to see you fight handyman.
Okay, I got you.
It
makes sense.
Because it makes it more entertaining.
It is pretty entertaining.
Yeah.
It's a struggle against these guys. And if I go on these, I'm pretty sure, from my memory, they will knock me off. Let's check it out. Let's see what happens.
All right.
Well, I got a...
Well, he's not a handyman.
He's got a rocket launcher.
He's a horny guy.
Shit, he's got a rocket
launcher. He's a horny man.
Shit, I'm getting rocked.
These enemies are starting to look really cool.
Yeah, they're wrecking me. They're wrecking my Ralph.
So the prediction is that you think that you can probably beat this in a couple episodes?
I mean, that's what I thought, but it's starting to get a lot harder.
That's if you don't die.
From my memory...
That's if you don't die.
Like, oh shit, that gets thrown electricity at
me. Ah!
That's outrageous. From my recollection of this game, we're pretty damn far.
Okay. Fair enough.
Yeah, so I'm not entirely sure.
Yeah, and there's no rush either. I mean, like, I would encourage that, yeah, if you could beat it, beat that shit.
Yeah, I mean, I'm trying my
best. Crush this game!
It's just I'm up against a lot of fucking Randys in the air. Get my drift.
Bunch of Randys.
Yeah, they're all in the air and I can't get to them.
They all want their cheeseburgers.
They're not Mr. Leahy's.
Mr. Leahy, we can't be together anymore. Check out the Trailer Park Boys.
Yeah, the show's great. I haven't watched the new season.
Fucking
though.
Great show, that is.
Have you watched the new season?
I watched the whole season.
There's season 10 now.
Yeah, I watched the whole season.
Oh, okay.
With Snoop Dogg in it?
Yeah.
Fucking great, great fucking season.
Yeah,
sure.
I haven't watched it yet.
Oh, you haven't watched it yet?
Yeah. Okay. No spoilers.
I won't spoil anything, but I'll say this.
I'm sure they just smoke weed and, you know, rob people.
All right, so I'll give you one little spoiler, but it doesn't hurt. Basically, Snoop Dogg and, God damn it. Snoop Dogg basically, like, makes a, like...
album?
A certain kind of, like, weed.
Oh, with Ricky?
With Ricky, yeah.
Oh, okay.
So, like, and that's about it. But it fucking blows them off their ass.
They
fucking love it. And Snoop Dogg's actually in the series for, like, three episodes.
Wow, that's pretty insane. Yeah, that
he's,
they got him
yeah,
out.
He's not just a cameo for one episode, and he also has other guys too. Like there's another dude that's like a comedian that's known mostly for his like pot jokes and stuff.
Oh yeah, that one guy.
Yeah, he's that one guy. Everybody knows him.
Just
that
the
one.
Weed comedian.
The weed comedian. Yeah, yeah, you know what I'm talking about though.
Damn it!
Why he's in it. Yeah, it's just really fun to watch, for sure.
Damn, dude, the handyman's on there, but I can't get to it. I'm not sure why. It's really fucking annoying.
So what's the objective right now?
So I just have to go to Comstock's house, but I'm in combat with that handyman who's on top of that, whatever that is.
Okay.
That floating ship.
Yeah, where's your girlfriend, though?
Like, look, I can't unlock this. She's, like, chilling all... shit.
There
like,
she
she's
is.
She's like, boo-hoo.
She's like, boo-hoo. She is boo-hoo right now.
I just can't.
She's waiting for you to do something.
Figure it out. I can't open any of these stupid things. Like, there he is. See? But he's so far away. And none of these things get to him.
So the goal... Well, weren't you really close to him before, though?
Yeah, I thought I was.
Because what you did was you hopped on a ship that was close to him, but the ship's not even there.
Yeah, I don't know, man.
That's what you did.
I don't know.
So let's try to figure out how to get there.
I don't know.
What if you go in front of the statue? You maybe reach him then.
Wait. What statue?
Right to the left. Right to your left. Yes, go in front of that statue. Can you shoot him?
I don't think I'm hitting him. There we go.
There we go. Yeah, we saw that hitbox.
Yeah, but he's got a lot of health. He's gonna take forever.
So you think there's a different way to do it?
Yeah, totally. I don't know why I can't get up to him. There's gotta be a way to get up to him.
Well, she just gave you more ammo.
Yeah, I'll just keep bombarding.
So you could just... Yeah, exactly. Keep shooting. They're Molotovs, basically.
Yeah, but this ship keeps moving.
That's the whole point of the reticle. The reticule, whatever it is. Yeah, like he said, reticule. Whatever it is. It's showing a downward motion.
Alright.
Yeah.
Shit, I'm out of ammo.
Well, you're hitting him, though.
Yeah, but I didn't kill him. He's got a lot of life.
Yeah,
full life.
I agree. There has to be a different way to do it, though.
I'm not sure what it is.
That can't be the way.
I feel like he's supposed to
is
come down.
Is that Hitler?
Down. No, it's just a decoy.
Oh.
I feel like he's supposed to come down, but maybe he isn't supposed to come down. I'm just fucking it up.
Let's,
maybe I'm supposed to shoot him from
let's
here.
Let's not say it's a glitch yet.
No.
Oh, he's almost dead, though.
Probably supposed to shoot him from here.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah, his health is depleting, at least. There you go. You did it. You did it.
Yeah.
You did it.
Seriously.
Yeah, baby.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
Unlock everything.
Remember to use your Vigors, at least.
Yeah, I'll try my best. Where, I was just go over there.
No, okay, well,
yeah,
the,
right.
the arrows are telling you to go the other way.
No, the arrows telling me to go that way. Alright, I'll go that
yeah,
way.
The other way.
Fuck it. I mean, there's tons of other doors that could be unlocked. I also gotta buy some arrows.
Might as well.
Not it. Ah, fuck, that's not it either. It's over there!
Oh! Okay, well, how do you know? Is there like a specific way to tell like which
Well, I can
one?
Tell like these items. I just was looking at it really quickly. And the items that it's selling, you know what I mean? Fuck, this doesn't sell stupid hand cannon? Did I pet? Oh, there it is. Okay. Because those were selling... This one sells like upgrades for guns, this one sells upgrades for Vigors, and then the other one just sells ammo and, you know, whatever. Health.
Okay.
Shit like that.
Cool. The more you know.
Yeah.
Brr, yeah, brah, brah.
Brah, brah. Oh, fuck, we got a new one. Bronco.
Oh, baby.
Oh, baby.
For Sparta. I love these animations.
Yeah,
and then you watch a little anime. Like, don't skip it this time.
No, I won't. I only skip one or two.
Yeah, I was like, when I was editing, I'm like, damn it. Cactus, why'd you skip these? These are fun.
Yeah, they're fun. It's because I've watched them all. So I'm like, ah, whatever. It's one of, like, people are throwing shit at you, you can absorb it.
Look at the imps. Toss it back. That's so, they're so cute.
The little imps.
Yeah.
Like, hey, we're coming for you.
So a magnet.
Yeah, so, or like a little explosive frag.
So you gain energy from something, and then you can.
I can absorb people's tosses at me, but I don't like that one. I'm not a fan of it. Do you want me to show it? I can show it.
Yeah,
off.
Definitely show it.
Okay. I haven't really shown them all. I'll try and show them all from now on. I'll
it's like kindergarten, dude. Show and tell.
I'm sorry. You have to. I'm just the type of person who is just like flying through this shit.
You're getting used to it.
Yeah.
Yeah. You're forgetting that you know you're there's an audience.
Yeah. So YouTube.
You just have to imagine that
YouTube is real.
That there's lots of people.
Alright, I just upgraded my hand cannon all the way. I upgraded my volley gun all the way. I'm still rich as shit. So, I mean, I could upgrade some of these other Vigors that
We're still rich, guys. Don't worry.
Dude, I am.
We ain't poor.
I'm going to upgrade my electricity because I keep using that. Electricity. So now my electricity is all the way boosted up.
Yeah, so we'll be hiring an electrician soon.
So I'm going to save the rest of my
money. With our riches.
Yeah, give me some money.
Yeah, so much electrical, you know, in our hands.
Shit, we're up against more enemies. There's a lot more story, just let me take it easy. Oh, and it's Sniper Town? Damn it. What the fuck is it?
Oh, damn it, I don't want to be a part of Sniper Town.
Dude, damn it, I don't
Could you imagine, though, like, have you ever had this thought before?
In real life?
In real life, like, you're just walking in a city and, like...
Dude, fuck that.
Or, like, okay, if you're watching, like, The Walking Dead or for all those people out there that have actually ever had this thought before, like, have you ever in your life thought that, like, when you're watching a movie or something, it's like that they're trying to survive and shit, or like a TV show where they're just trying to survive? Have you ever thought that the possibility of, like, just some random sniper can just end the show?
Like, I didn't think you were gonna go there.
Just fucking knocks him out. Pew, pew, and the show's over.
Kills Rick from The Walking Dead. He's dead.
There's no fucking show left because...
That'd be pretty interesting. I wish that they would do that. With one show. I mean, that's what they kind of do with Game of Thrones. That's why people like that show so much.
I think they'll do... Okay, it's possible if... They don't want to make it a cash cow.
Yeah.
If it's the kind of show where they just want to end it.
Yeah.
Oh, and I think you're onto something. Like you're saying, with The Walking Dead, they basically made a new series of it, kind of like a
Oh yeah,
I forgot what it's called, but they made a new series of The Walking Dead.
I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, where it's like a whole new cast. My theory on that was because like. The characters of the old are getting old, getting tired. They're, you know, they need to create new drama.
And that show's gonna end eventually.
So they have two camps. They have like this one and this one. So it's just a way to keep the franchise constantly making money for them, and a way to do it. For what we're saying is, when you're ready to fucking just pull the plug on the last one.
Yeah.
Just fucking end the season with the sniper, just boom,
yeah,
like
right.
I'm the fucking guy.
That would be really interesting. If they
yeah,
did.
Exactly.
That would really be a game changer.
That's how you do it.
Yeah, just change everything.
Yeah.
Oh shit, I can go down here. I'm gonna check this out real quick. There's gotta be something down here. Oh fuck, there is.
Oh geez, they're all like, hey, hello.
Yeah, I just murdered them all. That's how quickly I murder people.
And then your girlfriend is just like,
fuck.
Like, shoot me.
She's like, oh, boo-hoo.
Let me get into a blast radius. I will survive.
She's like the droids.
It actually turns me on.
She's like the droids from Star Wars. They never get shot.
Yeah. God, that's another thing with movies. Another trope with movies, man. It's yeah. Like, it's like, they're always escaping the bullets. It's just like, why?
Yeah, the
like,
main character.
How?
The main character, right?
Even in the water. Like, I watched Shanghai Nights the other night.
Oh, gosh. I've never seen that.
No pun intended, but, like, Jackie Chan is, like, saving Owen Wilson from drowning.
Oh, yeah, that movie.
And it's like...
I have seen
the bullets
movie,
go into the water, and somehow Jackie Chan... Just,
he dodges
just, he's
bullets.
Just swimming. He's not even dodging.
Yeah.
He's just swimming. But
he avoids it all.
But all the bullets just seem to avoid him. So yeah. It's just kind of like...
And like he later on just shoots everyone one shot, no problem. Mows everyone down.
Exactly.
I mean, he probably didn't do that.
Yeah, and you give him the benefit of the doubt because it's like, all right, well, he's the protagonist.
Yeah, we got to keep him alive.
We have to make him seem powerful. And people like to root for him, you know, but like
sometimes... Yeah, but it's still like a really cliche story. It's been rehashed a billion times.
Exactly.
Fuck, another volume, man?
And no. You're a fucking writer, and you're actually a good writer, too, so, so you know what you're talking about.
Yeah, I'm working on a different story right now. It's like kind of like Fight Club in a way, in the sense that my character's
is a great movie.
He's like fucked up in the head, because he keeps drinking a lot, and every time he drinks, he hallucinates.
Yeah, okay, so that's actually a new thing that you're working on.
Yeah, and he doesn't know he's hallucinating, and he thinks that he time-traveled, but I'm gonna right now it seems like he time-traveled in my book. I just wrote chapter 11 or 10, and he does time traveling. I wrote time traveling aspects to it. But he's going to end up that's going to be a really hallucinogenic state that he went through because he's been drinking so much. And he'll realize that a lot of, because after he time traveled, everything changed.
Yeah.
And then he's going to, everything's going to go back to the way that it was. And then, so it's you're going to question whether or not he time traveled at all. So that's going to be basically my story.
Interesting.
And then the last chapter, I'm going to do this crazy sci-fi reveal where it's oh, he did actually time travel. It's just that things went back to the way they were. Because I'm going to make him go to an insane asylum, and he's hallucinating that there's a person. His neighbor is real when he's been hanging out with this guy, and that guy's not real whatsoever.
Sounds like you put a lot of thought into this so far, which is...
Yeah.
Which is what a writer does.
So. I mean, yeah, the way that when I write stories and whatnot, I just pretty much try and I think about it all as much as I can. That's what writing a story is. That's what telling a story is. You're just always trying to move the story forward, and the way to do that is by thinking about it, you know? Right. By planning it out, by writing the plot or thinking about the way that you want to tell the story or where your characters are going to go, and then you just kind of fill in the gaps, and the only way to do that is by writing. It's by doing it, you know? You just sit down and fucking do it.
Bravo. Yeah, it's you know what? It's exciting, and yeah, I can't wait till you get a lot written.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just gonna keep doing it. I'm not gonna stop.
Well, that's the whole thing. It's just I've heard this argument before. It really comes down to basically whether you do it or not.
Yeah, I mean, it is just, you gotta put the work in. Regardless of whether or not I become successful or that becomes my career, I don't give a shit. I just really enjoy doing it.
Yeah, it's the equivalent of how lazy are you? A lot of people are lazy.
Yeah.
So, you can either A, seize the day, and be like, I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna do what I want to do, what I need to do to progress further, or I can just, keep thinking about it. So,
sure. Right. You could just be like, I'll do that some other day. Put it off.
Exactly. Yeah. And that's the thing that a lot of people actually have to deal with, especially people trying to create art.
Yeah.
And because you know that you have the idea, you have the
thing. It's all in your head.
It's all in your head. Exactly.
Put it in the world.
But are you going to fucking just? Are you just going to do it?
All right. So I think we're. We'll get back to that conversation in a second.
Oh, absolutely.
But right now we're in front of, I think this is Comstock's house, or we're...
Oh, this is huge.
No. So we're at Lady
Just like Comstock's dick.
We're at Lady Comstock's grave, actually.
Oh, Lady Comstock.
So this is Lady Comstock. We're at her grave.
Currently. Oh, shit.
So, yeah. But yeah, I mean, that's basically all creativity is you just gotta put in the work. And, the way that I'm all right at writing is that I just kept writing and writing.
And you can't stop. Yeah, that's back to the original point, is yes, you just must just constantly just keep writing.
Yeah, I can't stop.
You can't stop doing it.
If I ever stop, then I'll stop, progressing. I'll stop
the moment you forward. If you think about it, the artist, the successful, blooming artist, they don't become successful because they stopped.
Yeah, and they're always changing.
They kept going.
Yeah, they're
regardless of what situation was happening in their life, they just kept going.
And good artists just get better, so that's so it's the just goal, you know?
Yeah, so it's just boom, 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 exactly.
So I think now I have to go and This is all out of memory. I'm pretty sure I have to go and fight like three. No. I have to go and look for a grave because I think we were at her house or something. But there was a lock on the door. That was her house, Lady Comstock's house, and there was a lock on the door, and the lock was for her hand. And so we're going to get her mom's hand.
Okay.
Out of the grave.
What's funny though is I'll relate this to Doom actually. One of the episodes that hasn't been posted at the time of this recording, at least.
Uh-huh.
That's actually one of the puzzles, is that you have to find a person's hand.
It's a pretty common theme.
It's a common theme, yeah, exactly, like with a lot of movies.
Yeah.
Like, or like an eyeball.
Oh, yeah, that's
true.
You know,
like, you gotta get somebody's eyeball and scan it in the thing.
That's Minority Report, a lot of Minority Report.
Which I haven't really watched.
You've never seen that
That's
movie?
Tom Cruise, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I haven't really watched a whole lot of it.
Dude, it's not just that it's Tom Cruise, it's just a good movie. It was written... The book was written by Philip
Dick,
who's an amazing sci-fi author. They just made an Amazon TV show about one of his books called A Man in the High Castle. That's about if Hitler would have succeeded in winning World War II. And, like, he just makes really good, interesting, weird sci-fi. In my opinion, at least. There's also a movie called The Scanner Darkly that's based on one of his books.
Okay. He's,
but, yeah. Minority Report's good. I assure you, it's good.
There's Minority Report, and there's the what's the movie? It's not Ben Affleck, but the other one. Matt Damon! The Bourne Supremacy.
Oh, yeah.
I was told to watch The Bourne Supremacy, and I never really got around to watching that, but...
I mean, that's all the Bourne movies. They're actually coming out with another Bourne movie. They're restarting the series, because it's a cash cow. They're milking it as much as they can. Those are books, too, though. I never read those, and I doubt I will, because that's just, like, pure suspense and action. And that's not really my bag.
It's not your bag. Well... Yeah. Well, Cactus's bag is more of the tea variety, you know. Tea bagging.
Well, no, I mean, I really like sci-fi, I like satire.
What the fuck is happening, first of all? This is your girlfriend?
Well, we tried it.
She's losing her mind in front of you?
Yeah, we tried opening this grave, and the mom is...
Oh, what's happening?
Materializing.
Oh, shit. This is crazy.
But she's materializing because of her powers.
Oh, shit.
Oh, she's fucked up.
Come to New York with me, right now. Let's stop this crazy vacation.
The power, that device. We opened some kind of tear, so she's just a tear. So this is like a major boss in the game.
Okay.
Motherfucker. She's like spawning people, and at the same time, she's... Yeah.
Interesting. So this is like a very significant plot point.
Yep, you bet your ass it is.
Okay. All right. We'll take it from the writer. I actually read what he does, and he writes very well.
Yeah, I do all right.
So I trust his opinion. Oh. And he's actually writing history as we speak.
This thing's OP.
You think so?
Well, yeah, I boosted it up, so it's super powerful now.
There she never changes.
No, she's always just helping out, regardless of whether or not she's mad or whatever.
She's like a level of comfort.
Yeah. She's always there.
It's like when you feel like you're lost in life, she'll throw you a fucking bagel.
Fuck yeah, right? Yeah. You never know when you eat a fucking bagel, man.
She'll be like, here, egg sandwich.
You're like, whoa. What? Like, this is exactly what I needed in this instance.
Thanks, babe. Appreciate it.
Oh, yeah, my fire is, like, so powerful, too. I shouldn't be alone. It's too late.
This is really cool. It's a very spooky atmosphere going on here. I like it. I like it a lot.
She's powerful.
Duh.
But I'm clearly more powerful.
So clearly.
She's gonna sit down.
And I like how quick you reload that too.
Yeah.
Is that a power up?
Yeah. I upgraded. It's terrific now, look at that. Oh yeah.
Boom.
Boom. Give me that ammo.
Did you see that there's a prompt that said catch ammo?
Yeah, but I couldn't get it because she died before I could grab it. So I didn't get it. Fucking A.
Interesting, though.
But that was from, Elizabeth. Oh, shit.
Oh, is it the twins again?
Yeah, but I don't know where they are.
It's like the music, though. Lutessi? Oh, yeah, there they are. This condition
disagreeable. Perception without comprehension. It's a dangerous combination. Look. So they just said that they're exactly like Lady Comstock. They're dead and alive at the same time, which is why they're ironically digging their own graves.
Oh, that's fucking, that's genius, and that's a great fucking time down in the episode, actually.
Yeah,
I think. Wow. So sometimes, you know, irony is like the greatest, I think.
Storyteller.
Yeah, storyteller, actually. A lot of people don't understand irony, but it's just one of those things that you get over time. It's just kind of like, I don't know.
Feels good.
It feels extraordinary, like, once you, like, you grasp the concept of irony. For the most part, irony is just kind of like... The way that I can explain irony that might help people is that, like, what helps you get somewhere actually deters you from getting there. That's one way of looking at it. I mean, a lot of other people can look at, like, different ways. Cause I don't know. That's just my way of looking at it. It's a really good scope of, like, controversy and interpretation. But anyways, with that said, I think it's a good time to end the episode.
All right.
Let's do that. Yep. We'll see you guys next time, and I'll talk to you.
All right, later.